since it was a relatively small minority of people that built the Eagle, was the expectation on Kol Yisrael to really jump in and maybe suppress those 3,000 people that sinned, rather than just being lenient to what was going on?
Yeah, you know, it is a good question, because on one hand, you know, we always talk about chay to egel, and how this is such a stain on the entire Jewish nation, and we still bear the consequences of the chay to egel to this very day. Rashi quotes a chazal that every punishment that Am Yisrael gets for any sin is still connected a little bit to the chay to egel. But then you read the Chumash, and you say, you know, this wasn't something where everybody was worshiping this golden calf. I mean, there were 3,000 people that were killed. Now, 3,000 people out of 600,000 men from 20 up and a population probably around 3 million people, this does not seem to be a very, very great number. So, are you saying what?
Yeah. I have a question.
Yeah.
One is to follow up on that question. It says that there was also a magefa, the Negev, and the Kodesh Bar, and the Torah doesn't say how many people.
It doesn't say how many people.
So it could be that a lot more died, although the census seems to be, because of the census before and after, it seems the numbers are equal.
Yeah.
But then who died in the negative?
It might be a lot of the Erev Rev. That might be a possibility, because the Erev Rev are not included in the census. Now, in terms of your question, again, first of all, Rabbi Matalan is correct. Maybe more people did die, that we don't know the numbers. But the second thing is that Jews have a very heavy burden. We are responsible not only for the actual sins we commit, but for the sins that we endorse, that we didn't protest, that we simply let people do it. It was tolerable. Chazal, we become co-conspirators. Chazal say, if you're able to protest, now I don't mean throw rocks, I'm not talking about that, but if you're able, that's a different thing, that creates Chilul Hashem, but if you're able to stand up and protest evil, and you simply remain silent, it's no real excuse to Hashem. I didn't do it. I didn't murder the guy. I just watched. Reuven murder Shimon. Not my fault. I mean, let's go back to Moshe Rabbeinu. Moshe Rabbeinu sees two Jews fighting. Well, first he sees the Egyptian hitting the Jew. He intervenes. Moshe Rabbeinu sees two Jews fighting. Moshe intervenes. I mean, what's the lesson there? It's not enough to simply stand back and say, I'm not involved. So the Chet HaEgel is another example of that. It's a very difficult burden. It's an achrayus, but that's the idea of all of the Jewish people are our raven, zeh lazeh. We are responsible for each other.
But then shouldn't Aaron Cohen galvanize the troops and the rest of the nation to really...
Well, the role of Aaron is obviously problematical, because we know that Aaron took the jewelry and threw it into the fire, and Egel came out. Listen, all the Mephorshim say, actually the Chumash itself seems to say it pretty clearly, that Aaron had a strategy of buying time. Aaron was hoping Moshe to come back, and therefore he figured, because like this, he figured if he would protest, they would kill him. Now, it's not that Aaron was afraid of dying. Aaron was not afraid of dying, but Aaron was afraid of the divine retribution that Hashem would bring on the Jewish people if Aaron would be killed. They already killed Chor, which is Aaron's nephew, and there's a verse that says, if you kill a Kohen and a Navi, Chor was a Navi, Aaron is a Kohen, there is no forgiveness. So again, I want to point out, it's not that Aaron was a coward in terms of his own safety, but Aaron literally felt that all of Klal Yisrael would be endangered had he been killed.